Why does email with a lot of BCC’ed recipients bounce? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. Using Outlook, I send 10 emails per day with 50 addresses in the BCC area. When sending to Australian addresses where I live, I have no trouble. Now I'm trying to send to addresses in the USA, sourced the same way as the Australian addresses. However, with these USA addresses, I am getting an absolutely large number of bounced emails. What could cause this? Honestly, I have to ask, how is it working at all? Because what you're doing is honestly almost designed to fail. I want to go through exactly why that is, who we blame, spoiler, spammers, and what kinds of steps you need to do about it. To be clear, BCC is good for some things, right? If you want to like send a copy of an email you're sending to a coworker, but also make sure your boss sees it, but you don't want the coworker to know that the boss got a copy, BCC is perfect. In other words, BCC is fine for a few recipients, right? Something on the order of maybe 2, 3, 4, 5. It really is going to depend on your email service provider, as we'll see here in a moment. BCC is not good for exactly what you're doing. It is not good for a large number of recipients. And here's why. This is exactly what spammers do. You've probably seen spam that you've received where it's from somebody you don't know, it's to somebody you don't know, and you don't see your email address involved at all. That's because you were BCC'd. And the issue, of course, is that spammers will often BCC a large number of email addresses at the same time. Now, that's not to say that BCCing is bad. But it can be, in this kind of a scenario, a sign that your email might be more likely to be spam, because it's what email spammers do. Spam detection is difficult, and what we're looking at here is just one of maybe a couple of hundred different factors that combine in spam filters to basically decide whether or not a piece of email is likely to be spam. In your case, in the case of the question, you have three things that are actually marks against you when it comes to spam detection. One, it's using BCC. Two, it's going to a lot of email addresses all at once, where a lot is something that's defined by the email service providers. And it may be going to several email addresses at the same time on the same domain. In other words, you might have, of those 50, maybe 10 of them all go to a Hotmail account. Hotmail sees that as 10 emails arriving all at once to email accounts on their servers, and that's kind of like spam. And of course, in this specific case, we have one more strike against you, and that's for the USA addresses. This email is coming from overseas. Again, another common characteristic of spam. So, what's the right solution? How do you solve this? How do you send the emails you want to send? Well, the right solution is not to send, say, one email with 50 recipients, but to send 50 individual emails where the recipient is actually in the to line. It's clear that this email is destined for them. Now, the problem, of course, is that that's a whole lot more work. Sending 50 individual emails is a chunk of work. However, there are programs specifically to do that. And in fact, I use them. They're called email sending services or email newsletter sending services or whatever. There are two that I'll mention here. I use one called Aweber, aweber.com. The other one that you've probably already heard of is MailChimp. Most of these services have free tiers with some amount of limitations, but it's at least a way to understand how the service works. What it boils down to is you craft your message, you put it on the service, you upload or subscribe the email addresses you want to receive that message, and you tell the service, send it. That service then automatically sends, instead of one email to 50 recipients, it will go through the work of sending 50 emails, individual emails, to those 50 recipients with their email address at the top, and potentially even some customizations if you want to in the body. But the bottom line is that they are handling this heavy work of sending individual emails. That's the right solution. And by the way, if you don't want to do like these newsletter services, another approach is to use groups, Google Groups or groups.io. They're intended as discussion forums where people can talk to one another on a mailing list. But in fact, they are also usually capable of setting up what's called an announce only list. And this is one where, yeah, there's one person or some set of people that have the permission to send to that list, and everybody else is just a recipient. Same thing, individual emails to each of those recipients. Now, two more caveats. One, the email address that you're sending from matters. It's one of those 200 factors that, you know, work together to determine whether something is spam. For example, if you're sending from a Hotmail account, slightly more likely to be considered spam. On the other hand, if you're sending from your own domain that you've had for years, okay, that's somewhat more reputable. And the other, of course, is the service itself, right? Does the service itself have a good reputation? The ones that I've mentioned, they do. There are other services out there, other approaches that may or may not have good reputations, but the reputation aspect of this is also something that's not to be overlooked. But again, the solution here is simple. If you're going to be doing this regularly and sending out an email to a lot of people all at once, some kind of service that will send it out as individual emails is the best approach. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/28292. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.